Please welcome to the stage Mr. Devin Freeman, Governor Tim Walz, and President Bill Clinton.
National Guard, or on the football field, in Congress, or as governor, we Tim Walz is someone who has spent every day trying to make a difference for the American people.
Trump wants to take us down of chaos and division. town hall on Univision. I don't know if someone saw this. And he got pressed and asked, I wouldn't call them hard questions, I would ask them honest questions, and they asked him, why are you and J.D. Vance making up stories about people who are in this country legally, putting them at risk, spreading disgusting, untrue stories about folks in Springfield, Ohio, rural Colorado? That's what he's been doing. It tells you just about everything you need to know about this. These lies that they're saying, Republican officials are telling them to stop it. And then they tell lies about the Republican officials who tell them to quit telling lies. Because that's what they are. But look, let's be honest. There are outsiders coming into communities, stealing and moving jobs away, and making life harder for people living there. And they have names, Donald Trump and J.D. Vance.
Medicare, when you get to be 60, you start paying attention to Medicare.
trust me. Because healthcare costs can bankrupt them. But Kamala Harris put out a plan that says, you know what, especially for rural communities across this country, Medicare will start paying for home health care for our seniors.
Thank you.
explanation is terrible. Because the ACA was transformational because it protects us from pre-existing conditions. Because you don't have to be a business genius to understand. Insurance companies want to charge premiums, and then what they really like to do is not have to pay out from them. One way to do that is only insure healthy people and let the sick people, as Donald Trump would say, just get along however you can. That doesn't work. You create the pools together where all of us have an opportunity to get basic human rights and health care.
There is one political party now that is pro-democracy, and that's us, right?
Trump's plan to seize unprecedented power for himself isn't hypothetical. It's written down in budget 2025. And the rest is coming right from his mouth. Last week, one of Trump's closest buddies, who he pardoned, Mike Flynn. Trump's former national security advisor, and he's a contender to be that job again in the White House. He would ask, point blank, if he would lead military tribunals to carry out executions if Trump wins again. Mike Flynn answered, "We have to win first." He followed up that to make sure that we understood just how batshit crazy he was. He said, the gates of hell, Mike Flynn saying this, my hell, will be unleashed. This is the guy that Donald Trump wants to hand the keys to the federal government over to. So look, if there's anybody in your life who really meant when Donald Trump said he called for a bloodbath after this election, if they think he's just talking, I have to tell you this. You remember 2016. You remember the way he talked. This is not that Trump. This is something much more deranged, something much more desperate, maybe to stay out of prison. And with J.D. Vance there, there are no guardrails around him. You know how people look. So look, Lord knows Republicans in Congress will have the courage to stand up to him. So there's one way to stop it. We need to go vote and win the election and make sure none of this happens.
Closer to yours, a southern, speaking like a Midwesterner, a decision she made was tell Walz. It said a lot about what kind of president she'll be. First decision Donald Trump made was J.D. Vance.
Think about that.
this when I describe what the decision is for North Carolina and the country. A presidential election is just a great job interview for the most important job in the world. And since you do the hiring, you have to decide what the criteria for the job are. And in effect, the American people make that decision every presidential election, over and over and over. So how do you decide? What questions will you ask? Here are the questions that I hope you'll ask. Which candidate will take us forward? Which will take us backward? Which will give our children a brighter future or a darker, more uncertain? Which will make us more united? And which will relish in every new division? Which will make us all feel heard and seen? Regardless of who we vote for. And when the election's over, will we all live under the same set of rules? That's a big deal in a democracy. It's not just about who gets the most votes. It's what rules do you play by when it's over. We've got a Supreme Court that virtually said, once you get to be president, you can just make up the rules. And he keeps talking about how he wants to get even. He may have to call out the military of our own people. The danger within. I suppose that includes me. And basically he's asserted the right to go after anybody that he thinks in his wisdom is a threat. But you sign up. The oath says you promise to preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution against all enemies, foreign and domestic. And he said, I think I'll start with domestic. Bring me the army. Now, I used to like President Clinton. I once said only he and Ronald Reagan were the great presidents since World War II. But I've had a change of heart. And I think he needs to go away for a long time. And I'm not going to execute him, although I could, under the Supreme Court ruling. But I think I'll just send him to the Colorado Supermax for the rest of his life. So I've already got a petition ready. I want him to transfer me to Guantanamo. Because when you're 78, you're a lot more worried about being too cold than being too hot. We're laughing about this, but let me tell you something. Being president is a sacred duty. And the sheer joy every day, I'll never be able to play on this. Even the terrible days, when they were trying to tear my head off, there was always something good you could do for somebody. Sides that bash the living hell out of the other side and tear up the peace. preaches, it says we are supposed to perform a more perfect union. And I can tell you, and I know both the candidates pretty well, I think Kamala Harris is the only candidate.
What happened? We lost.
happened everywhere in the world. Now what happened? The administration, President Biden, and all his economic team, and Vice President Harris, they've been trying to get the inflation rate down, and it's been going down for 3 years, and finally the Federal Reserve has lowered interest rates, which is going to together those things moved we have to buy. Doesn't create any jobs for anybody. It's not like the CHIPS bill, where President Biden got the support to start manufacturing computer chips in America for national security and economic reasons. This is just stuff, anything. Buying pencils for your kids to go to school with, whatever. If you do that, it amounts to a sales tax on every family. These tariffs will hurt lower and middle income families the most because most Americans spend a larger percentage of their income on goods and services, the very things that we don't produce here and others. So the economists say Trump's would cost middle class families about $4,000 a year. And by raising the price of essentials like gas, medicine, and prescription drugs, which also he wants to do, it'll become worse. Please talk to your friends about that. And then there's the jobs issue. You know, we're about to finish a four-year plan, which is to produce more jobs than any four-year plan in the history of the United States. seize the opportunities to give us a stronger middle class with greater ability for more people to work their way into it. We want to do things, and we're tired of wasting time talking about crowd sizes. Should realize that more than ever before in my lifetime, the fundamental protections of the economy, of the Constitution, majority rule, minority rights, individual rights, the rule of law, same set of rules behind them, those things are in great danger. And I'm telling you, I think it is an enormous opportunity that we've been given to elect nominees. Clearly up to the job. Tim Walz is clearly up to the job. They will bring us together and move us forward. Will everything be perfect overnight? Will everything be hunky-dory? Will you agree with everything they do? No. This is the real world. But you still get a chance to do as much good for as many people with one decision. So go out there and win this, because the next 20 years than the United States, not one.